Most families from Hakibare sub-county in Kabarole district take their children to schools in Chenjojo district. Parents walk their children to the bridge to ensure they cross safely. The same bridge has now broken down. As children, this has disturbed us so much while we are going to school. Most of these children are so young. It is us, the old, who first help them to cross before we go to school. We always reach school full of mud.
I have to first remove the shoes, stockings. After that, I should put on them when I go to school. When I reach school, that's when I found the lessons have already started, and I end up missing some lessons.
Residents say they are also finding it hard to transport their agricultural produce to the markets. Movement of people between the two districts has also become a nightmare. This road has helped many areas in the region, including Ntezi 1 and Ntezi 2. We have plantations of tea, and as of now, we are no longer able to pass here while taking our produce to the factories. We have around 1,000 students crossing this same bridge to go to school. In January this year, the government cut the budget meant to facilitate the maintenance of roads in Kabarole, Bunyangabu, and Chenjojo districts. Chenjojo district that was supposed to get 250 million shillings in the last quarter of the financial year 2021-2022 instead received 87 million shillings, while in the current quarter they were supposed to receive 260 million shillings and they ended up with 67 million shillings. In Kabarole, the district council received 30 million shillings for the construction of the roads, with the authorities describing the amount as just a drop in the ocean.
It's been more funds that have been allocated in the district, but we have not received yet. Around 108 or 130, we have not received that money. It is still in documents only. So there are so meager resources that we are receiving as a district as far as road construction is concerned. And a district to construct a bridge, it can take about two or a whole financial year to construct one bridge as a district. So as per now, as the resources are in the district, we cannot manage this.
The residents also accuse their leaders of doing nothing to get the bridge fixed. We have been standing here, coming here, and all this time, not even one leader has come to speak to us. This problem is instead worsening. The district engineer says we are on our own. We have to fight on our own. Does that make sense? Leave that aside. A man drowned recently in these same waters and nothing is being done. Our children use this same bridge. When will this be fixed?
It joins the two districts. They have teamed up with my brother, chairperson of Kienjojo District Local Government, Mr. Gilbert Rubaihayo. We have both visited the site, and also we have dispatched a team of our engineers to go and find out what can be done.
Report by John Antusingwire for the news.